I think I've sorted out the minis according to the mercenaries. So let's take a marker and start with Ivan Dolvich. And this is the mini. He has a nice rifle and some kind of Russian thing on his head. So I put on the deck his initials, Ivan Dolvich. Then Rudy Lynx Roberts, and I think this is the guy. Start it here. He has a simple gun, he has a thing on his shoulder. So RLR. Kyle Shadow Simmons. He's holding some kind of knife here. So I think like so. He will be a good match. Because if you have minis, you need some kind of sorting. Sheila Scope Sterling. I had a bunch of ladies and I'm not very sure about her, but I think this is one of the base game figures. She has a sniper rifle, but the other one, other girl also has one, so let's keep her aside. Dr. Clifford Highball holds a gun and some kind of medical kit on the back, so I think he's a good match for DCH. Then Corporal Len Anderson, he's a good mechanic and he's a leader, and I think this is the guy pointing things. Nothing special. So then CLA. Fidel Dahan. I wasn't sure about this figure because it has a metal detector. There can be more, but I think he's the best mechanic. And the only thing he does is smoke cigars. He's unarmed, so he doesn't wear an army. He wears a metal detector. And he has a beret. So, FD. That's Scav. Some kind of British guy. Average mechanic. I'm not sure, but I think this could be a good fit. He doesn't have a beard. He has a rifle. That could be somebody else. Not very sure yet. Let's keep him aside. Cynthia Fox. Oh no, Jarlene. Raven Higgins. So sniper rifle. is good with people. Has some medical gear. So I think out of the two ladies, this girl is most eligible for being Charlene. This could be a medical kit. They both have short hair and some non-revealing shirt, so it's hard to tell which is which. This could be Sheila as well. But Sheila has no medical gear. At least she's sitting on a barrel. Let's go with elimination. Corvin Cosmos looters. I think this is the guy. he has a pistol. This also has a pistol. And it is on his right hand. Yeah, so like so. He has some kind of baseball cap, as you can see. And this is the only one with a baseball cap. So CCL. Cynthia Fox Guzman, the third lady, but this one is in particular has two pistols and also has more slots. She has some kind of medical kit skills, but this must be her. So CFG. Next up, Larry Roachburn. He's not good at anything. And he has a knife and obviously has cut himself a few times. And he has a beard. So, this one has a knife. And the beard. But it could be somebody else as well. He has a bulletproof vest. This one is also bulletproof vest, so I go for Larry Roachburn. L. R. As you can see, I'm not very experienced with miniatures. Bobby Steroid Kontarski. I think some of the stretch goals, he's a good mechanic. He's a very good mechanic, so he has this wrench and he has a small gun. Well, he's carrying some kind of toolkit. And I think you can't really make out the details. Well, he has some extra things in his back pockets, I think. He's wearing a shirt. I painted over it because I didn't know the color, but it should be something like blue. So I think this is Bobby Steroid Kontarski BSG. So we have three left. So by elimination, this must be Scav Heron. TSH. And that's done. And then the two ladies. Both good with people, one good a mechanic and one a medic. So which one is mechanic and which one is a medic? This could be a mechanic with a mechanical toolkit. And this girl doesn't look like a medic. So then this would be Cynthia, Charlene. And this would be Sheila's scope, because she's called scope. But they both have. Yeah, this one has a more of a scope, and this is more like. Not really sure what it is. I think it's also a scope. They both have scopes, so I can't. Well, let's forget about that. You can see for her, you can see her ear. For her, you cannot see her ear. So that would be like so. Charlene. But then the medical kit doesn't. And what is it? Is the medical kit? If it's not a medical kit, then. It could be a toolkit. So you can go either way. So these are all the miniatures. The base game ones and the the Polish add-on. There's also. Well, did I keep it? There's also the undergrounds. Those have minis as well. I can zoom in a bit. And obviously I need also some kind of box for the extra minis. So this is the underground. It has a simple setup. Underground rules. Setup. Spawn cards. Underground access. Not sure how this is going to be played. I think it just has a scenario 13. And so you start there, and then you go to the underground part, I think. Okay, now. Oh yeah, the crepitus monsters look like so. So they have eyes and some kind of hard shell. And a reddish belly. So what I did was... paint them like so. Yeah, I did a few, and they look really distasteful. I'm not sure if this is, it might be thematic, but it looks like a real bug. And there you have the monsters. I think these are the spawns or something. Some kind of worm. You can paint them any color you like, but not the bland version. I wouldn't suggest that. These hold 8 extra minis, and maybe I can put these gray ones inside such a box. I haven't decided yet on the box. I think they would fit, but then the insert would have to go, and I would have to use the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, the 7 missing ones. Like so. It would be a pity to remove the plastic insert. I'm not really sure yet how to organize the polished minis, but I'm very happy with them. Of course, this means another paint job, but what can you do? And we have an idea for the... Oh, this is the crepitus, the full-grown one. So greenish and yellow, and this